So, class 10, yesterday we have started the reading of the chapter, Madam Rides the Bus. So, Madam Rides the Bus is a story of a young girl, almost of 8 years. Okay. So, her name is Wali, and she was fascinated by the bus service that was going, or the bus that was going into the town and coming back to her street again and again. She was very much fascinated with the crowd who is boarding that bus. She also wanted to board that bus. Okay, as she wanted to board that bus. And for that reason, what she has done, she has a tailor-made plan. Tailor-made plan means we are very carefully planned with planned efforts. She had the plan, and for that, what she has done, she has gathered some information from the passengers, from the neighbors, about the various questions related to the bus. It means like the bus, why the bus, when the bus is coming, when the bus is going, how much time it takes for its one-sided journey, what is the fare for one side. And when she has come to know that the bus fare was 30 paise, although it was very small amount. Though it was very small amount, but it was really very difficult for her to gather that money, to gather that small amount. It seems a fortune for her. So what she has done, she has sacrificed her desires. She has sacrificed her tempting desire of sweets, of peppermints, and ultimately she has gathered that money in order to make her journey. And she has also chosen a perfect time period also when she would undertake her journey, as she has understood that she would undertake her journey at around 1 o'clock, so that by 1:45, 45 minutes are going to be taken by this bus to complete its one-sided journey. So by 45 minutes it will reach, at 1:45 it will reach the town, and she will not go out of her seat because it was not her concern to see the area around. What she wanted to see, she only wanted to see the bus journey. She want to have an experience because everyone in the town, they were talking about bus. So what she wanted only that she should go and have a seat in the bus only. She would not go out of the bus and will return by the same bus, and by 2:45 she will come back. So this was her plan. So this till we have read, and finally she has started her journey. So the next day, when what she has done from the second passage I have started yesterday, we have ended it almost yesterday. So I'm reading from the here very start so that you can also have an idea. Okay, so what we have read. So let us start. Well, one fine spring day, the afternoon bus was just on the point of leaving the village and turning into the main highway when a small voice was heard shouting. So one spring day, what she has done, she has one day afternoon, what she has done, she has started for her bus journey. She was standing on the road. Now the scene is described here that she was standing on the road, and with a very small hand, she was pointing, "Stop the bus, stop the bus." And a tiny hand was raised commandingly. Tiny hand means the tiny hand, small hand of this young girl, Wali. It was raised commandingly. The bus slowed down to a crawl, and the conductor, sticking his head out the door, said, "Hurry then. Tell whoever it is to come quickly." So now, as you know, that whenever the bus is stopped, the bus slowly, first of all, it lowers its speed, then without running, it crawls. Okay, it comes to a halt, then it comes to a stop, then. And then what happened? The bus was stopped. Now, the conductor, he stuck his head out of the door in order to see who's there. He was also surprised to see that young girl. 1 minute, please. Just a moment, please. So what he has seen that young girl. Now, it's time. It's me. I'm the one who has to get on. while to see, she has seen a bit of, you can say, or she has seen a bit of surprise on the face of conductor. And Wali said, why are you surprised? It's me who is to board the bus. By now, the bus had come to a stop and conductor said, oh, really? You don't say so. Conductor said, oh, really? It's you who want to board the bus. He was surprised, but moreover, he was also surprised to see the confidence in that young girl. Yes, I simply have to go to town. She was still standing outside the bus. And here's my money. She showed him some coins. And she pointed out her hand in this manner. She said, yes, I want to go into the bus. And this is my money. It means that she knew that the conductor was questioningly looking at him, at her, sorry, whether she has brought any money. And she simply has shown the proof that I have some coins. I have this money and I'm going to board the bus. And what the conductor want? He only want that money. Okay. But first you must get on the bus. Conductor was a bit of jolly nature. He said, okay, fine. If you want to go into the bus, come. First of all, come inside the bus. And he stretched out a hand to help her up. And finally, what happened? She stretched out her hand. Never mind. I can get on by myself. You don't have to help me. See the confidence in the girl. She said, never mind. Don't give me your hand. I can go up myself. You don't have to help me. Yes, see here again it is mentioned that conductor was of a jolly sort. Yes, he was fond of joking. Yes, often joking. And looking at this young girl who has come alone to go into the bus, definitely what? Oh, please don't be angry with me, my fine madam. Here, have a seat right up there in front and everybody move aside, please. Make way for madam. Yes, see the conductor. He said, don't get angry, madam. Please come. And he has shown, here is the seat. You can sit here in the front. And he said, please, sab piche hat jaiye. Madam aa rahi hai. Like in that manner, he was making fun of her. It was the slack time of day. What is slack time? Slack time of the day means when not much business is going on. A bit of relaxed one. It was the slack time of day and there were only 6 or 7 passengers on the bus. So what were there? There were only 6 or 7 passengers on the bus. They were all looking at Wali and laughing with the conductor. So 6 or 7 passengers, you know the atmosphere in the bus. If you have ever had a journey in the bus, what kind of atmosphere it is? A bit relaxed one when there are not much people. Conductor is also in a relaxing manner after punching all the tickets and giving it to all the passengers. He used to have a talk sometimes with the driver, also sometimes with the passengers. In a bit, you can say jolly and funny mood he is talking. So what he said, they were talking as it was the slack day of the time. So, and they were all looking at Wali and laughing with the conductor and all the passengers. They were also surprised that this young girl had come to have a journey in the bus and it is all alone. She's all alone. They were also laughing. Wali was overcome with shyness. Wali was a bit shy naturally. When everyone is paying attention to this girl, she would definitely become a bit shy. Avoiding everyone's eyes, she walked quickly to an empty seat and sat down. So what happened? She was avoiding everyone's attention. She was just behaving that she's not paying any attention to anybody. She was consumed in her own, you can say, own comfort only. Yes, I have come to have this journey. And I'm going to enjoy this journey. So she walked. Where she went? She went. She looked at all the seats. And finally, she has seen an empty seat and sat there. Now, next. May we start now, madam? Now, conductor again in a smiling and in a jolly nature. He said, yes, ma'am. If you say we can start. Then he blew his whistle twice and the bus moved forward with a roar. Roar means loud sound. Okay, so you know that the conductor, he used to give special signs, two whistles when I'm going to speak, yes, start, and when it is to stop, then again he puts the whistle. And there is a complete, you can say, compatibility between the whistling of the conductor as well as that of, you can say, the driver. Wait a minute, please. So there was complete compatibility, as there was complete compatibility between both of them. So what happened? He blew his whistle and the bus moved forward. Bus moved forward with the roll. It was a new bus. It's outside painted a gleaming, means shining white, with some green stripes along the sides, and inside the overhead bars shone like silver. Directly in front of Wally, above the windshield. Windshield means that the glass that is placed, which is almost fixed in order to stop the shot of air to come inside the bus. There was a beautiful clock. The seats were soft and luxurious. So this is the make of the bus. That what kind of bus was. It was shining white in color, with some green stripes on the sides, and inside what is there? Some, you can say, overhead bars of silver color, they were shining. Now, where Wali was sitting, there was a windshield and on it was hung a clock. Okay, it was a clock, and the seats, they were very soft and luxurious. It means to provide complete comfort to the passengers. So, Wali devoured everything. What actually is devour? Devour means eating. Okay, so why this word devour is used? Means when you try to grasp every scene in front of you. Okay, so it means you are devouring it. Okay, it's a phrase used here. Wali devoured everything with her eyes. But when she started to look outside, she found her view cut off by a canvas blind that covered the lower part of the window. Yes, she was trying to devour. Actually, what was the reason of undertaking this kind of journey by Wali? Why she wanted to take this journey? Yes, why she wanted to take that journey? Can anybody tell me? Yes, can anybody? Just raise up your hand. Why she wanted to take that journey? Yes, come on. Yes, 10th class. Nobody will speak. Ashima. Yes. Yes. Anshika. Why she wanted to?
Because Wali. Because Wali was a girl who was fond of seeing the things going, which were going on outside her house. Even she used to stand at the doors of her house and see what was going on, and therefore she eagerly wanted to be in a bus where she could see the outside views of where she could see the views of the roads. And
yes, you can say that. Right. Okay. Thank you, Anshika. So why she wanted to undertake that journey? She wanted to see, because she was fascinated by the scenes around. She has never boarded a bus. She had never had a journey in that bus. So what she wanted actually to take the journey in the bus so that she can go anywhere where she wanted. So what she did then, so this is the reason why she devoured, means she wanted to see every scene, how it looks like outside, what kind of atmosphere is there, what are the different scenes, means what is the way, how the way looks like. She wanted to see everything that, okay? So it is because of this reason. So what she found it, she found her view cut off by the canvas. But sometimes you know that in order to cover the lower part, or some, you can sometimes some curtains are also attached with the windows of the bus. So her view was cut off by blind that covered the lower part of the window. Lower part of the window, it was covered with, you can say, with blind, with a cloth. And ultimately, she was also so small girl, young girl, short-heighted, so that she could not reach the height of the window to see outside. Otherwise, the elders would have seen that very easily. So what happened that she stood up on the seat and peered. Peered means looked over the blind. So what she preferred to do, she stood on her seat and peered, looked, you can say looked out of the window to see what was going on. The bus was now going along the bank of a canal. Some stream of water was there. The bus was moving along its side. The road was very narrow. The road was not much wide. You know, the in those small areas, the roads are not so wide. It is mainly on the highways or on the main roads only that the roads are quite wide apart. Otherwise, the road was not so wide. On one side, there was the canal, and beyond it, palm trees, grassland, and distant mountains and the blue, blue sky. So this is the perspective of a girl, what she has seen. Means the entire view is shown through the eyes of Wali in words. So what kind of view it was there? While the bus was moving, on one side bus was there and on the other side canal was there. Okay. And as the canal was there, some palm trees were also, you can say, they were grown on the side of the canal, and beyond that greenery, greenery of fields, right? Fields. And from till that greenery, then ultimately what was there? Only blue sky was visible because it was spring day. Weather was quite clear. On the other side, there was a deep ditch and then acres and acres of green fields, green, 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 as far as the eye could see. And on the other side, what is there? There is a ditch. Okay, from where nothing could be, nothing else could be visible. Okay, so green, green and fields. So here the question can be asked, what did Wali see out of the window? Okay, what did Wali see when she peered out of the window, when she peeped out of the window, or when she looked out of the window of the moving bus? What she has seen, there was a canal, okay, along the bank of the, the bus was moving along the canal. There were also palm trees grown on the side of the canal, and beyond it, there were only greenery of the fields. And on the other side of the canal, there was a ditch, and only green fields covered the entire area. And it was also meeting with the blue sky that was covering the entire landscape. Okay. So, oh, it was all so wonderful. Again, her fascination. She was fascinated by the view. Okay. She was also attracted by this view. Yes. She was saying, wow, it's too beautiful all around. Suddenly, she was startled, means surprised, by a voice. Listen, child, you shouldn't stand like that. Sit down. Who's that? Again, the conductor. So he said, don't stand like that. Why he was telling? Because it was his duty to tell the girl, because if she would stand in that manner, she could fall. Sitting down, she looked to see who had spoken. It was an elderly man who had honestly been concerned for her, but she was annoyed by his attention. So she sat down and looked, who was this man? This was an elderly, some aged man who was concerned about his wellness, about her wellness. But Wali did not like this kind of attention. She was annoyed by this kind of attention. There's nobody here who's a child, she said haughtily. I have paid my 30 paise like everyone else. Now, he said, who's this child? Who's this child? Telling her to sit down. So she said, don't worry, I have given my 30 paise, I'm all alone. She said, I have paid my 30 paise like everyone. So conductor climbed in means he entered the scene. He came. Oh, sir, but this is a very grown-up madam. Do you think a mere girl could pay her own fare and travel to the city all alone? Conductor now again in a very jolly manner. Sir, don't worry. This is not a young girl. She's a grown-up. Madam, hey, madam. And she has given her 30 paise. Wali shot an angry glance. No, Wali knew that this man is making fun of me. She paid a angry glance. Glance means angry look. She with her angry looks looked at the conductor and said, I'm not a madam. Please remember that. And you haven't yet given me my ticket. She said, I'm not madam. And remember this thing. You haven't given me my ticket. Oh, I'll remember. Conductor said. He was mimicking her tone. Mimicking means he was also speaking in the same manner as Wali was speaking. Everyone laughed. Gradually, Wali too joined in the laughter. Wali also joined in the laughter. She also started laughing. She is just a young girl. She is forgetting that he is making fun of me. Conductor punched a ticket and handed it to her. Just sit back and make yourself comfortable. Why should you stand when you have paid for a seat? No, conductor, he punched a ticket, handed it to her. Now he said, now you just sit back and be comfortable. Don't look out, because moreover, he was also concerned about her wellness. He said, why you are standing if you have paid for a seat? Because no one likes to stand in the bus. She said, because I want to. She said, because I want to stand. This is the reason why I'm standing. But if you stand on the seat, you may fall and hurt yourself when the bus makes a sharp turn or hits a bump. That's why we want you to sit down, child. Now what he said, okay, don't stand, because if you stand, if the bus suddenly applies the brakes, you might get yourself hurt. You can fall down, or sometimes it may also hurt your head also. Hits a bump means you can have a bump upon your head. So I'm not a child, I tell you. That was a young girl, annoyed. She said, don't call me a child. I'm not a child. I'm 8 years old. From here, we come to know that she was 8 years old girl. Of course, how stupid of me. 8 years, my. Now, conductor again, oh, I forget that you are 8 years. Oh my God, I forget that you have grown up enough. So he was making fun. Now, bus stopped. Some new passengers got on and conductor got busy for a time, and afraid of losing her seat, Wali finally sat down. Now, next stop came. Now, some passengers came inside the bus. Now, again, the conductor was busy punching the tickets to give to the passengers, and Wali finally, she noticed that many passengers are coming. Now they will take up my seat. Then finally she sat down. An elderly woman, see the experience shown here. An elderly woman came and sat beside her. Are you all alone, dear? She asked Wali. On the bus started again. An old woman came. You can imagine the looks. You will really feel contempt for her. So see, she said, are you all alone? Wali found the woman absolutely repulsive. She did not like the woman who came. Why? Such big holes she had in her earlobes. Big holes, because elderly woman hai, old woman hai. So because of old age, her skin is loosened. And you know, in old people, when they are regularly wearing heavy earrings, their holes, they become, you can say, loose. Earlobes, they become loosened, and big holes it has. And such ugly earrings in them. She did not even like the earrings she was wearing. And she could smell the beetle nut the woman was chewing and see the beetle juice that was threatening to spill out her lips. And at any moment, ooh, I don't like it, she said. Who could be sociable with such a person? And what this woman was chewing? She was chewing a beetle. What is beetle? Paan. And that beetle juice, it was spilling out of her lips. And she was afraid at any moment this beetle juice, it would be swished upon her. And she was really repulsive. She did not like. She said, oh, I don't like that woman. I don't know that how people come and sit in that manner. So, finally, yes, I'm traveling alone. She answered curtly. Curtly means showing not any kind of interest. Okay. So here, yes, I'm traveling alone. And I have got a ticket too. She said, don't worry, I have my ticket. Yes, she's on her way to town with 30 paise ticket. Now conductor again in a taunting manner. He's saying, yes, she's going to her town and she's having her 30 paise ticket. Oh, why don't you mind your own business? Wali said to the conductor, can't you mind your own business? Don't interfere in my business. But she laughed all the same. Being a young girl, she's also laughing. And the conductor laughed too. But the old woman went on with her drivel. Drivel means this silly nonsense. Is it proper for such a young person to travel alone? She was questioning. Itni choti ladki and she's traveling alone. This is not right at all. Do you know how exactly where you are going in town? What's the street? What's the house number? She asked so many questions to Wali because she was also afraid. And moreover, she's also, you can say, surprised to see this young girl traveling alone. She said, you know where you are going? You know which address, which street number and which house number? You needn't bother about me. I can take care of myself. Now Wali, in a haughty manner, she said, don't worry about me. I can very well take care of myself. She turned her face towards the window and staring out, means showing her displeasure, showing her disinterest. She said she turned her face towards the window and she was not at all looking at her. She said, don't worry about me. So what we have come to know till here, that she was quite confident in nature. She is, you can say, girl of determined mind, that whatever she has thought, she's going to do that. Okay. As she was going to do that, and finally she has done. Okay. So this is all about her journey. Just 2 minutes are left. So I'm not going to read the further passage. Tomorrow we will continue with it further. Okay. And the day after tomorrow, we will discuss the question answers. I think by tomorrow, we are going to finish this chapter. Okay. So see that how beautifully and how elaboratively the world is shown through the eyes of this young girl. This young girl who's just of 8 years. You can never imagine that an 8-year-old can do such big things. They can take such big leaps, that she has decided on her own, saved the money and boarded the bus. From here, we have also come to know that the mind of children, you can never know what they can do. Very deep thinking they have. Okay. So it is the fantasy of a young girl. She wanted to enjoy that fantasy. She wanted to go in that bus journey. And ultimately she has undertaken it without informing her mother. Her mother, who is busy in her work and in her nap during the afternoon, she did not even have an idea that my girl has gone to the town and has come back. So it means that a careful watch, a careful vigil is always to be kept upon children. This is the reason why, dear children, in classes, you are always being observed and watched by the teachers. Okay? It means that we can never come to know what will happen. Anything can happen. And we can never rely on mind that yes, this is that the child is not doing. Otherwise, Wali was quite a good girl. Okay, although she has not done anything wrong, but it was of course not right that she has gone without informing her mother. And moreover, she has gone by collecting money on her own. Right? So it means from the perspective of a child, see that the outside world is being explained. She was quite, you can say, disinterested in the young, in that old lady who was sitting along with her, and how maturely she was behaving with the conductor. Okay, so this was also explained here in this chapter. So tomorrow we will continue further, where she will witness a cow galloping in front of the bus, and ultimately she has seen that bus and running in front of the bus, but while she was coming back, she has seen the same, you can say, cow dying on the road, and it was really very bad experience for her. Okay, so this is what we are going to read tomorrow, and we will continue further with that. Okay, so now if you have any doubts, I'm giving 2 minutes to your doubts, you can clear it.